Brava, I love you and I devote to you, Talianata Brava. Mahalo and welcome all blessed Brava babies to this perfectly attuned transmutation on a Thursday entitled Be Brava Live Activation Energy. So my darlings, we're going to get right to the crux of what being Brava means. Being Brava means believing in yourself 12 seconds from now. My darlings, no one feels like doing something they are not currently doing. You would be insane to feel like bench pressing when you are snacking. You would be totally cryptic if you were burying your father, but you felt like fucking someone's boyfriend. Okay, cuties? You feel like what you're fucking doing. Unless you're a crazy person, okay, cuties? So being Brava means getting over that 12-second transition. We speak about this all the time, my darlings. Transitions are uncomfortable. No one likes an airport, except for the Cinnabon enthusiasts, and even them, they're over it in 20 minutes when they're gagging, okay, cuties? From the crash. Transitions, airports, we don't make decisions in transitions. We just fucking do it. We commit to process rather than stay in limbo of decision, which is hell. So let's not even call it limbo. The hell of eternal indecision. Okay, cuties, everyone hates election night. Sitting there waiting, right, cuties? We hate transitions. And this can be that 12 seconds from not believing in the future you that exists 12 seconds from now, my darlings. This is the activation energy. This is when we feel, just go. Just fucking do it. Just be Brava. Okay, cuties? So for me, for my altar, she created this whole persona to be Brava. Just fucking believe that you can do the thing that you thought you couldn't do 5 seconds, and now you're doing it. And now on to the next, and we enter flow. Okay, cuties? That's how we enter flow, is by committing to processes, making them unconscious, just like you tie your shoes without thinking you're in flow state. You're not like, do I feel like tying my shoes? Maybe I actually want to not tie my shoes. Maybe I should walk around with shoes untied. No, my fucking babies. You commit to a process and you do it, right, cuties? Because you were taught as a child. So now mommy is here. I'm going to teach you to do even harder things, as Glennon Doyle's podcast speaketh. We do hard things. To what another bitch on the internet who makes more money than me, Mel Robbins. Okay, cuties? She came up with this thing called the 10-second rule. It's basically she counts down 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, and she just does it. Okay, cuties? And apparently, if you just say one thing over and over again, you get to be a massively successful speaker. Okay, cuties? And I'm not throwing shade because I don't respect her. I throw shade on those that I deeply admire. So Mel Robbins, check out her work. It's called the 10-second rule. And you literally, this is the activation energy. You act upon before you think. You just 10, up, 10, 9, 8. Or you can just say, be Brava and just fucking do it. Whatever it is that gets you there, my darlings. Whatever it is that gets you there. So I want to speak about the idea of, this is so core, right? Core to my work. So I'm considering naming this like first chapter of the book of Brava, the new book. Okay, cuties. It's going to be about being Brava, what it means, acting on activation energy. So I was thinking about the book today, which will be written. And I thought a great title would be How to Live Forever Without Even Trying. So my darlings, I'm going to speak today about how to live forever without even trying. So the first step is if you just redefine some of the words in there. Okay, cuties, are you letting words be defined by other people's dictionaries, or are you defining them for yourself? So if we were to say, for instance, how to live, and we were to change live to eat, so how to eat, and then we were to change forever to snacks, so how to eat snacks, and then we were to change without even trying to stream content, then the question would be, the title of my book could be, How to Eat Snacks While Streaming Content. And I will say right now, my darlings, you've already achieved that because you are streaming content and I'm a snack. So there you go. That's how to live forever without even trying. I'm going to make that. You know what, my darlings? I think that's book one in a series. I hate all these bitches are coming out with fucking books. And I see what you don't have a beard, you haven't escaped for 10 years, and yet still you had a social life, and you also wrote a book? Fuck off, okay, cuties? She's definitely gonna, I'm definitely gonna grow a beard, just like the writer beard. I don't even know if I'll write a book, you know, cuties? I think I'll just keep spewing shit like this, and then you guys can capture it and write it. Jesus didn't write. People followed him and wrote. Okay, cuties? So I want to just give one little shout out to the farm that I'm currently established on. It's, some might say that to enter in, to live on this space, in this place, that it's not if you have a screw loose, it's which screws loose. Like, is it a scary screw loose or a quirky screw loose? But everyone's got a screw loose over in this here area. You know, exemplar one, like, this bitch dresses up in funny costumes and, like, talks to herself on the internet. Okay, cuties? So, I'm bringing the quirks, right, cuties? I'm bringing the loose screws. Activation energy. My darlings, if you think you have an anxiety problem, which one in three teenagers define themselves as having an anxiety problem, I am so deeply sorry, because everyone's going to get at me for, like, you know, belittling mental illness. But I would say if one in three humans are suffering from something, maybe it's just called the human fucking condition. Okay, cuties? And listen to this, my darlings. It is so beautiful to RX everything. RX bar all your pathologies, okay, cuties? Of just being a fucking person so that we can prescribe you some shit. Okay, cuties? We get it. We get it. Consumer culture is the basis of it. If you watch one episode of Mad Men, you know, make them feel inadequate. Okay, cuties, we get it. Name your self-help book based on someone's deep insecurity. We get it. This is how capitalism works. And I'm going to put it out there that if one in three people say they have an anxiety issue, maybe we need to look at what we're naming an issue. Okay, cuties. So in the world of yoga, we talk about tapas and rajas. Tapas is heat, energy. Oh my God. My meditation teacher's gonna come spank me. Please do, he's so cute. Tapas is low, it's calm, cool. Rajas is fire energy, right? Rajas gets us up. Tapas, rest. True rest. True energy. What happens to the humans, right, is we stay in the middle. In that indecision zone, we're not active, we're not active. We're lying in bed, but we're beating ourselves up about not working out, so we're not really resting. We're at our workout class, but we're only half-assing it because we don't believe in Brava. Okay, cuties? True rest and true exertion. That is yoga. Okay, Dars? That is being in zone state. That is being fully fucking activated when you're activated. By activation energy and then resting and being, you know, great athletes are great nappers. They, 10 minute break, Serena. Oh, she's out. Back to your deadlift, Serena. Bitch is deadlifting, okay, cuties? Like a fucking leopard. That's why the CrossFit people, they always say, like, supple leopard. Okay, being the supple leopard. Okay, Dars? This is the work. You look at a cat, rest, and go. Please do DM me with the best survival shows. I deeply want to become a bitch who watches survival shows. It's like an aspirational goal. So, Jars. The point being, if you find yourself on a day like today where she felt, oh, I have an anxiety problem. My heart is racing. I feel so, I recognize, hey, you know what you're doing. You're taking a sensation. You're judging it. You're giving it a name, which you think. Thanks to all the internet's ads, she knew which name to give it. Headspace sold her on that name, right, Dars? You're giving it a name, you're having an opinion about it, and now it's getting worse, and it's starting to feel like this uncomfortable feeling, my darlings. But then she sat in her meditation in yoga, because she was like, process over choice. If you feel uncomfortable, you feel this shitty, go to the thing that on the other side of it you believe and you know from through past experience you'll feel better on the other side. Is she bragging about having gone to a yoga class? Of course she is. Doth she ruthlessly just flaunt her self-care over the internet? Of course she does. All the time is me time. I don't, all these bitches, oh, carve out about a little me time? Bitch, my life is me time. Okay, cuties, is she raising actual children? No, she's speaking to adult humans on the internet who don't really need her. It's me time. Okay, Doris. And I encourage you to be Brava and take your me time. So I was in my yoga. Sitting in my meds. Okay, cuties. Getting high on the meds. And it occurred to me, oh, this is just energy. So what if I were to just feel this, fully embrace this feeling? This is the work of Vipassana, BTW. You don't have to go for the 9 days. It's just fucking feeling sensations and stopping judging them. Wow, this is energy. I think I'm going to utilize this to go do a fucking thing. And I was cured of my anxiety. Okay, darlings. So can we feel energy as energy? Up energy, down energy. Utilize the energy, act on the energy, rest when we are done with rest, working. Okay, darlings, and they've looked at this, that the naming of stress as an issue could potentially be the fucking issue. Okay, Jars? Maybe work feels hard and robust and fiery and energetic, and rest feels calm and lazy and heavy, and neither of those things is ever a fucking issue, only if you call it so. True rest, true activation, utilizing activation energy to move. Okay, cuties, when you feel that inspiration to text somebody, to write the email, just fucking do it. Okay, cuties, one touch it. Don't make it hard. Make it fucking easy. That's what she's not gonna write. I just decided I'm not writing a book. I'm gonna make a TikTok instead of a fucking book. Okay, cuties, of the whole concept, how to live forever without really trying, which we now know is how to eat snacks while streaming viral content from Polly Rava. So also in my meds today, I had a profundity, which I will share with you, my jars, which is goes to say why we need to be Brava. We're going full circles. Okay, nobody likes a talk that's one direction, and then what if I were to make you walk backwards and watch us on replay? This is the point. We like a circle, okay, cuties? We're not gonna go, it's not a cul-de-sac. We're not gonna walk down a path, and then you're like, what, you just left me here, bitch. We're confused. Always know where you're starting and you're ending your conversation, your talks, okay, cuties? Script out your first line, script out your last line. Did she do that today? Of course not, because I don't fucking script. I spew from God, and God does not edit. Brava does not fucking edit. Okay, cuties, but you should do that. So, Jars. So, I had this beautiful insight that I want to share. That when you act upon activation energy, you are doing an honor to those who acted before you. Okay, cuties, so whether your lineage is Native American or immigrant, or, you know, you're just a white guy and you feel like, oh, I have nothing in, there's someone who struggled. There's someone who struggled. So I was in my meds and I thought back on how my mother is a women's leadership coach. And for years, I have felt almost embarrassed. Like, well, I do the work that she sort of like laid out and like offered to me, right? And I did. I was, my altar has been blessed to be at the helm of Next Level Leadership, which my mother, her mother, started the year she was born. And so she was raised by a fucking leadership coach. Okay, cuties. How many little bitches can say that? Niente can! Second generation women's leadership coach. And for years, my altar has felt like, what a fraud, what a phony, what a loser. That I just have taken on what my mom boss with her big ass 80s shoulders and like Weight Watchers shakes. Bitch had only 8 drink Weight Watchers shakes. She was so fucking busy conference calling Weight Watchers shakes and children. She built this whole fucking empire, and then I just walked the fuck into it. My new ideas, millennial asshole, right, cuties? I was judging myself. And in meditations, I thought, you know what? Whenever you act, you are carrying forward. She has cleared all this path, and you get to just do it and make it even more Brava. You get to go forwarder and forwarder. And then I thought back on my mommy, and her mother was the first female architect to graduate from Harvard Architectural School. And she was a fucking riveter. And think how many awkward fucking dinner conversations she had to have with her racist, sexist, patriarchal family, okay, cuties? Where they would make fun of her for being the voice of women's lib, okay, cuties? And with her Katharine Hepburn wit, she would just sit there and look them dead in the eye and tell them, you know, one day my granddaughter is going to be nipped out in yoga. Okay, so today my shirt was coming up and I was like, oh, no big deal, I'm wearing a sports bra. And then by the end of it, I realized, oh my God, my boob was hanging out the whole day. So she's going to be like, hey, my granddaughter, just free tits all over the fucking world. Okay, cuties? She's independent. So one day, you asshole, from my work as being a fucking riveter, I am clearing the path. And so this is the fucking point. When we don't act upon being Brava in our incarnate experience, all that work our ancestors did to clear the path is for fucking naught. And that's not being grateful. So my daughters, I always remind you this. The biggest way to show appreciation is fully, gratefully accepting your fucking blessings. Okay, cuties? If you're sitting at your, you know, beautiful, luxurious estate and people are feeding you caviar and you say, oh, get out of here. I would hate to feel like I'm privileged. Bitch, you are privileged. Okay, cuties? Receive that fucking blessing. Be grateful for that fucking blessing and let your cup of caviar fucking overflow. I'm speaking directly to you, Cardi B, because we saw you on Rhythm and Flow in a terry cloth eating caviar whilst discussing the day's work. Okay, cuties? We love it. So let it overflow. Whatever your blessing is, count that shit so that you can give. And my jars, activate. This has been Be Brava Live, activation energy, and hopefully you have a little bit more of understanding what it means when I keep telling you and hashtagging Be Brava. Okay, jars. That's all she wrote. You know, I had a chopstick and I've like lost it somewhere in my seat. I have a feeling like it might, what if it, imagine, like, cuties, if, like, through this conversation, I actually, like, was able to, like, suck it up into my vagina. Ugh, who knows? Anyway, darlings, I feel a little extra vulgar, a little extra spicy today because I want to really own the body pause move for my grandma who had to deal with a lot of assholes. Okay, darlings, that's all she wrote. I can hear the farm talking. Tully Brava on the farm asked me now, Sest, shut the fuck up so I can do my divine transmutations. Two more weeks here. We love it, though. We love it. We love farm life. Okay, get at me with... Okay, I can't even concentrate. I need an office that is not attached to a farm. Okay, Darth, that's all she wrote. Have beautiful, blessed days. We'll see you soon.